usually on a Friday afternoon when I've got the junior kids, we would do some kind of fun activity because their attention at that point can be a little bit challenging. So on the first Friday that I had them, we did, we learned a song. We learned a Black Eyed Peas song. And I just found that the kids loved it. Where is the love? I thought it had a good message, and I was also thought it would be kind of in a rhythm that was enough for them to get. It turns out it was way too fast, and they didn't quite get all the lyrics except for Sophiza, who's an amazing rapper. Anyway, so then the next week we were also doing narratives and we were doing descriptive writing for level three, and so then the next week. We started to talk about similes and metaphors, and I think it was probably a week or so after we'd started talking about them and getting our heads around what they were about, we decided to come up with a simile for each person in the class, or a metaphor for every person in the class. So the kids were making suggestions, we wrote them all down on the board. And between then and the next class, I turned them into kind of a bit more of a rhyme. So I extended the first sentence to make it rhyme with the next, with whatever it was that the kids had decided on. And then, I think the lesson after that, I came with a short little kind of song that I'd written, and we practiced it, and I just found that the kids were really excited about it. Mm-hmm. And I put it to some classic rap music, and we went from there. When we first wrote the similes or the metaphors for each person in the class, there was no rhythm and there was no beat. So it wasn't until I made a sentence that kind of went prior to it that I found there was a little bit more of a rhythm. And when I gave the sheet to the kids to practice, naturally, you know, they kind of created their own rhythm with what was written there. Mm-hmm. Once we filmed ourselves, once I filmed them, I got them to try and learn the simile or metaphor off by heart, so they didn't need the paper to look at it. And we sort of one by one, I filmed each of them. And so I recorded each of the kids. I just did it on my mobile phone, and then I took it back to the program, the editing program that I know of called Final Cut Pro X. And we did listen to the beat. We listened to the song I was going to put it to. So they did kind of have that rhythm in mind, but we didn't sing it over the top of that. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so then I made the video. It took me a little while because I actually did it for week five when we had our Facebook week. I wanted to put something on Facebook that was a little bit more fun. And I showed the kids the film once it was made, and they just were beside themselves. It turned out it was to be something they were really excited to do. And I almost forgot to go over with them afterwards to say which ones are simile and which ones are metaphors. And when I did remember to do that, the kids knew exactly which one was which. And okay. I just found that it had really concreted their knowledge.
Rolling.
Muhammad has so many fans, but he's as serious as an exam.
Marwa is never firm, she's a clever little bookworm.
From Jerry never hear a peep, but he's definitely not a cheap.
Jean's super sweet, maybe, she's innocent as a baby.
Daniel is not a fake, he's as mad as a snake.
Yeah! And a class project star, she plays a girl like Nima.
Betty never gets a foul, she is as west as an owl.
Mika is part of the fam. She's sweet as a very jam.
Jessa is doing well, Mina. When she loves, she is a hyena.
Kira is going to go far. She's as crazy as a K-pop star.
Sometimes could make you frown, but he's an entertaining circus clown.
Don is as cute as a minion. He really is one in a million.
Kaka never saw boss. She is as cool as a cucumber.
Asna's quiet as a mouse, except when she's out of the house.
Cat is clever sharp. He keeps his mouth shut like a trap.
Tim is a cheetah. Try as you might, you'll never beat a
cheetah!